Children, in this video, we will discuss about one important question that is being asked frequently in the examinations. How political parties can be reformed? In the previous video, we discussed the challenges faced by the political parties. Now, in this video, we will discuss how the challenges are overcome by the political parties. Actually, if you want political parties to reform themselves, who should take the decision? Not the people. It is the party leaders who should take the decision to reform themselves. If any problem or any challenge they are facing, they should think the ways and means to overcome the challenges. That is the reason why, but some political parties don't want to reform themselves, don't want to change themselves. That's why some recent efforts have been taken to change the political parties. Reforming the political parties means bringing change in their activities. So some recent efforts have been taken. Three recent efforts have been taken to bring changes in the political parties, functioning of the political parties. One effort was made by the parliament, that is, the parliament passed anti-defection law. Today in this video we will discuss in detail about what is anti-defection law. Another measure was taken by the Supreme Court. Supreme Court has taken a decision. Supreme Court has passed an order to the political parties to file an affidavit. So what is affidavit? That also we will discuss in this video. Then third one, order by the Election Commission to the political parties. So these are the efforts, various efforts were taken already to reform the political parties. So let us discuss the first anti-defection law. First of all, we should understand what is defection. Defection means changing. Suppose a person who got elected on Congress ticket, now he has become a Congress MLA, and the next day after 1 month or 2 months, he is joining in BJP. For the sake of cash rewards or for the sake of ministry. So other party will promise them, you come and join in our party, then our party will get enough support, majority, then we can form the government. Then if you help us in forming the government, you will be given a ministry or we will pay you money. So like that, in recent years, so many MLAs and MPs, after winning the elections, they are joining in other parties. So this is called defection. Now the parliament has made a law. Parliament has passed a law. And the parliament, actually, they amended the constitution only. They amended the constitution. It is a constitution amendment. By amending the constitution, now they passed a law. That law is called anti-defection law. Now, if any MLA or MP, if he jumps into another political party, his seat or her seat will be lost. So this is called anti-defection law. Because of this anti-defection law, now recently, so no MLAs, no MPs are jumping into other political parties. Once you are elected on Congress ticket, you have to remain as a Congress MLA for 5 years. If you are elected on the ticket of BJP ticket, you are a BJP MLA, you have to remain as a BJP MLA and you have to listen to the party high command. So that is about the one effort taken by the parliament by passing the anti-defection law. So now this anti-defection law has reduced the defections from one party to another party. Now, second thing is affidavit. So what is this affidavit? this effort was taken by the Supreme Court. Supreme Court passed an order to every candidate who is contesting in the elections, they should file an affidavit consisting of or giving the details of their assets, liabilities, or if any criminal cases or any other civil cases pending against them. So they should furnish all the details of criminal cases, civil cases, and they should furnish the details of their bank accounts, about their lands, buildings. So everything they have to furnish in the form of affidavit to the election commission. So it is compulsory, it is mandatory for every candidate who is contesting in the elections to file an affidavit before the election commission. So with this, what happened? What is the benefit of this affidavit? There is lot of information is available to the public. So public can go through the affidavit, they can understand, they can get lot of information about the candidates. If any candidate mentioned any cases against him or if, and public will come to know about the assets, how many crores of rupees they are having, how many lakhs of rupees they are having, how many acres of land they possess. So all the details are available to the public now. Now after going through these particulars, they can take a decision whether they have to support them or not. So that is the second effort taken by the Supreme Court. Now third effort. This effort was made by the Election Commission. They passed an order to all the political parties. So every political party now compulsorily they have to conduct their elections, their party's internal elections. They should maintain membership record. They should file income tax returns to the government. They should state their income, etc., etc., all other particulars. So this was the effort taken by the Election Commission. So now it is compulsory for every political party to conduct its internal elections. They have to organize elections democratically to elect the party president, vice president, secretary, general secretary, etc., etc. And every political party should have their own disciplinary committee to look into the disciplinary activities by the party members. So like that we can discuss these three efforts taken by the, one is about amending the constitution, one was taken by the Supreme Court, and another was taken by the Election Commission to reform the political parties. So besides this, some measures were suggested, some suggestions are given, some suggestions, these are all suggestions. So suggestions means suggestions only, it is not mandatory on them to follow or not to follow. So that is the reason why most of the political parties have ignored these suggestions. Anyway, today we will discuss about those suggestions. What are the suggestions given to the political parties to follow? First suggestion is that actually parliament should bring a law to regulate the party affairs. So parliament should bring a law to regulate the party affairs. But the political parties do not want these suggestions. After all, you know, who will make laws in the parliament? These political party members only pass laws in the parliament. Then why they will pass a law which is against their interest? So that is the reason why no political party is ready to pass a law to regulate the party affairs. That's why this suggestion is not liked by the political parties. And second suggestion is every political party should give minimum tickets to women at the time of elections, whether it is a parliamentary elections or elections to the state legislative assemblies. Every political party should encourage women. When they give tickets to women, then only women come forward for contesting elections. In most of the developed countries, actually you can see lot of women participation. There, if you look at the American Parliament, American Congress, or Germany, Britain, in Japan, in developed countries, in their parliaments, you can see the active role of women. You can find more women parliamentarians. But unfortunately, in India, in Indian Parliament, you find less than 10% of 550 members. We find very less than 10% women members only are there in the parliament. This shows that political parties are not at all giving tickets to women. So ours has become a male dominated society. So they don't want women to become MPs and MLAs. In the reader one cartoon also given, you see that reader one cartoon is given. So how the parliament male members are obstructing the woman to enter into the parliament. That cartoon also you can see in the reader. Then, but actually there was a bill proposed to give women 1/3 of seats to women. It was introduced during the time of Manmohan Singh government. But at that time what happened, Rajya Sabha has passed that bill, but Lok Sabha has not passed the bill because of that. That proposal could not become into a law. Now let us see, let us wait and let us, in the coming years, I hope this Modi government may pass that bill, woman reservation bill in the parliament. If it becomes law, then definitely women will get at least 1/3 of the seats are reserved for women. But right now that bill has not been passed. So, and also the political parties are also not ready to give minimum tickets to women. The third measure was state funding of elections. You know, elections means we have to incur a lot of expenditure. Elections means fighting elections means now it has become a prestigious issue to for every political party to win the elections. By hook or crook, they have to win the election, that's why they spend a lot of money. So that is the reason why they give sometimes tickets to candidates, to those candidates who could invest or who could spend more money. Understand? So that's why to overcome this challenge, some people have suggested the political parties they suggested the government only. Government only should give some money to the political parties to contest the elections. So how much money should be given to political parties, that should be decided by the percentage of votes they received in the previous elections. In the previous elections, how many votes they received, so that party has got, based on that proportionately money should be given. Or in case money is not given, we can give in terms of kind also. We can provide them paper or petrol or some other facilities, the telephone facilities, so that the political parties can utilize these facilities to fight the elections. Like that, these three suggestions are made to the political parties. But this third suggestion is not possible in India-like country. Ours is a developing country. It could be possible only in the developed countries, rich countries. Government could pay the fund to the political parties. It is not possible in India-like countries. So anyway, this session also not being implemented. So like this, we can discuss this topic, subtopic, how parties can be reformed. So to reform the political parties, some efforts were already taken and some measures are suggested to reform the political parties. But these are being followed. They have accepted and they are implementing also, but these measures they are not ready to follow. So like this we can discuss this subtopic, which is very very important in the point of examination, 5 marks specially. You have to mention these three recent efforts and these three measures suggested to the political parties. So thank you very much children for watching this video. In the next video, we will discuss on another topic. Thank you.